this is Cecilia, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to make this beautiful sifol card, perfect for Valentine's Day, for your special friend, your daughter, I don't know. There is a lot of people we love that when we can give them something really special in this day. And of course, you are watching here the beautiful papers full of flowers. I mean, this paper is really, really pretty, and I think it's perfect for this kind of cards. Of course, you are watching right now the seafoam shape, but I wanted to try and do something more personal for the person that you are going to give it as a gift, because behind the seafoam, you will see in a moment, there is a frame and a space for a place or write a beautiful sentiment. And this frame, in this case, is dimensional. So you will learn how to make this beautiful card. And I hope you like it and you can join me in this tutorial. Thank you. Wondering which paper collection is this? I use the beautiful Blossom paper collection. Some of the sheets are patterns and solids. Of course, I also use the Ornette metal key. And you will have the list of everything that I use in Graphic 45 blog. The base of our card, it's a piece of black cardstock that measures 12 inches, and with this 12 on top of the table, we will score at 3 and a 6 inches, and the paper measures in the other side 7.5. When we have all of this already scored, we need to make the flaps as you are watching right now on the screen. This is important because this is going to give the beautiful C-fold shape. And of course, to embellish it, we are going to use not once but twice pieces, one in the bottom and one in the top. This one is going to be in the bottom, and this measures again 12, and it's going to be exactly the same scoring lines at 6 and at 3 and at 6. Okay, and in the other measurement is for this 2 inches, and this is going to be in the bottom, but I have the idea to add another one on the top because there is a plenty of room to put to embellish the card with the beautiful, gorgeous flowers from this paper collection. So this is the other strip, and this measures again 1 by 12. In the 12 side, we will score again at 3 and at 6. So these pieces will give us the shape and the possibility to embellish inside this card. But also, we will need to add another tiny strips that you will see in a moment. I like to distress all the edges because this cardstock is not a solid black, so I don't want to watch the white in the edges. That's why I'm scoring. These are the other three strips that we are going to use, and this measure 4 by 1. And in the 4 on top, as you are watching there, I scored at 1/2 and at 3.5 in the 3 of them. Actually, I have to say, later I am going to add 2 extra strips. So you can cut it right now to have in total 5 of those strips. Now, the papers, this beautiful paper, it's going to be the base, and this is from the patterns and solids. It measures 5 7/8 by 7 7/16. then this is going to be in that place. Now for these two flaps, I already selected also two of them are going to be the same stripes, and these another two are from the 8x8 paper pad, and the name is Enchant. You are watching here how beautiful, beautiful, beautiful is this paper. And this measures 2 15/16 by 7 and 7/16. The four of them, these two as well as the other two, they are cut with the patterns in solid blue strips. This another one, and this is the order that I plan to attach it in the card. Of course, I decided to use magnets to secure the card, because the card is not going to be only the seafoam, as you already watch, but I planned to attach a frame inside, because it's a perfect gift for a friend in Valentine's Day, or for your daughter, your son. Just change the papers. Now the papers to embellish these strips, this one is from Patterns and Solids, and this is the paper that you are watching there, and we need one piece that measure 5 7/8 by 1 7/8, this one that you are watching on the screen right now, and the other two are exactly in the same size, and it is 2 7/8 by 1 7/8. Also, I distress all this graphic 45 paper, but and this time is with a brown, light brown ink. And now for this black strip, I use the same paper from Patterns and Solids, but now the measurements for this are the next. For the long one, it's 5 7/8 by 15/16, and the other two are 2 7/8 by 15/16, these two. And this will be a covering to embellish this piece. And these three bands that we are going to use in the pop-up element will be embellished with the same paper, and these pieces measure each one 2 15/16 by 15/16, and this will be on top of each one of these. Actually, this doesn't show so much because it's in the bottom and there is going to be a lot of flowers on top. You can skip this step if you prefer, but I like to cover it because it's going to be more resistant also for all the embellishments. Now we need this extra piece for the base, and this measure 7 by 7 1/2. So with the 7 on top, we will score at 1/2 inch, because we need a gap there that is going to be this 1/2 inch, because there is going to be a frame inside this card to add a picture and some sentiments, and well, we will see on the way. We also need two pieces of this Patterns and Solids paper that measures 5 7/8 by 7 7/16, and this strip is from the Enchant 8x8, and it measures 7 16 by 7 7/16. The other piece that we are going to add in the outside of the gap is also from the 8x8. It's the light paper, and it measures 1/2 inch by 7 7/16. And these are going to be placed, as you are watching right now, on the screen. So For make this dimensional frame, we will need a piece of black cardstock that measure 9 by 10.5, and will be scored on the four sides at 1/2 inch, 1 inch, 1.5 inch, and 2 inches. You just need to score one side, then turn it to the left or to the right as you wish, and do the same in the four sides. I am going to give you a scheme or appendix in which you can see exactly how it's going to be cut this frame in the four corners to make this dimensional space for a picture. This frame with this paper that is from the 8x8 and the name is Inspire, and I cut out four strips that measures 1/2 by 5 and four that measures 1/2 by 6.5, and I am just going to cover the top and the outside as you are watching here. And it's better if we glue down these pieces, well, the outside first and the top. We will do it later when the frame is all assembled, because I am going to show you, maybe you already know, how to cut the corners better to look better. And okay, these are the four pieces. If you want to decorate also inside the frame, you just need to cut two extra pieces of each one of these sides. Okay, now I am going to show you how I cut these sides with an angle. First, we cut until this second line. Then we will cut here in from one side to the opposite side that you are watching there, and then we will make the tiny flaps to make the corners of the frame more even. Thank you. Everything with the mats, and that wasn't my intention. I don't know what happened by my phone. I was sure it was recording, but no, it didn't. So I'm going to tell you where are the magnets. Below the, well, this is the kind of magnets, really flat. I add 3 magnets below this big piece. Yes, here you are watching below this paper, but you can use only 2. I mean, they are really, really strong. Then in this flap, there are another 3. And then in the top flap, there are the other 3. When you add the magnets, then you can add the papers on the top. That's all that you need to do. And as I tell you, with 2 in each one of the pieces, I think it's going to be enough. Okay, now the frame is ready. I also add the double-sided tape on the back, and that is going to wait. Now we are going to work with the seafoil card, and you are watching here. I also mat all these pieces, and also this piece has a magnet, and I add the magnet after I mat. So I am going to cover the inside magnet because I don't want to watch this magnet. But here you are watching how easy it is to attach the magnets on your projects, and that will secure the flaps. So this is the paper that I choose for covering the magnets, and of course the pieces measure exactly the same that the pieces that we are using for the outside of these strips. Okay, and now that we have this ready, we can cover the magnets and continue with the assembling of the C4 card. You will see how beautiful. I really loved to work with this card, and because it gave us, as I told you, a lot of place for embellish it. And when I was doing this, I was imagining this with a different collection, and trust me, with anyone, and this will be so amazing. Also, this is perfect for your album. Imagine a page of one page of your albums with this mechanism, and of course it's going to look really, really pretty.
Thank you.
is when I just realized that I need some strips on the top piece of the seat fold card, so it's easy to fix this. I just take the same measurement from the last one, well, from the last to the front. I took the measurement and I made a mark in the top part, and I just glue it in the way it should be. Then you just close, and the other flap, tiny flap, we will find the proper place to be glued. And I just attached two strips in this piece because I don't need three in this one. I am going to connect both top and bottom C-folds with pieces of acetate that measure 6 1/4 long by 1 inch width, and this will give us a lot of space and dimension to some layers. Maybe, I am not sure, I think they are about 3, 4, 5, 6 layers for embellish with the beautiful flowers of this paper collection. These are the pieces of acetate. I use leftover acetate from things that we bought. So this is going to be hide with all the decoration.
Thank you. Thank you.